Well, we're at Strbske Pleso for the final cross-country skiing event. The weather is absolutely fabulous. Clear skies. I can see the tips of the mountains. At last, it's absolutely gorgeous. The conditions should suit a reasonably quick time. We didn't get a lot of snow overnight, so there's no extra powder to worry ourselves about. It's the 30-kilometer mass start, the marathon, the prize, the big prize. And it looks the favourites when you look at the start list. It's got Russia written all over it. They've won the all three medals in each of the other two individual events for the men's, the sprint and the 10K. And they're odds-on favourites to do it again. They have the five fastest ranked skiers in the start. That man wearing number one, Andray Larkov, he won the sprints. But also in the Russian group, you've got Raul Shakirzianov wearing two. Andrey Feller, the gold medalist in the 10-kilometer, he's wearing number three. Artem Nikolaev has four on his chest. Ravil Valiakhmetov wearing number five. Others to look out for, Alexis Jeannerot of France, he wears seven. And then Arocho wearing eight. Yevgeny Velichko has nine, and Takatsugu Uda wearing 10. He's the main Japanese hope following the withdrawal of Hiroyuki Miyazawa. Alexis Jeannerot of France working extremely hard at the front of the leading group alongside Jakob Graf wearing 13, the Austrian from the Technical University of Liberec. These two setting the pace a little bit for the opening group, doing the hard work. The question really whether they could sustain it right until the end. The final bell, well, the bell for the final lap going, and it's still Jeannerot in front, and Graf working hard as well. And the Russians, the other Russians, you can see Larkov number one and Shakirzianov number two, settle quite happily in the middle of that pack along with the Japanese Uda. Nikolaev working hard with Larkov and then heading into the last lap. This was the break. This was a big break from Uda, the Japanese, looking to break that leading pack wide apart, really scorching up the snow on this uphill, really nasty uphill, but he took Larkov with him, the big Russian, not letting him get away. And that in the end was to prove key, because Uda couldn't keep it up. Nikolaev and with him the Ravil Valiakhmetov, Larkov and Shakirzianov, they swept past him. Nikolaev wearing four, Larkov wearing one. It's Larkov, the sprint champion, who cornered quickest and was into the final straight. He was being chased by Shakirzianov. It was down to these two, Larkov and Shakirzianov. Larkov working the poles hard in the final sprint. Shakirzianov perhaps leaving himself just a little bit too much to do. Larkov burning away from his teammates, coming over the line to take the gold medal. Shakirzianov took third, and it was Artem Nikolaev who stretched furthest. He had just a yard ahead of Ravil Valiakhmetov. So Nikolaev took the bronze medal. It's another clean sweep for the Russians. Indeed, look at that. The top five positions, six in the top ten. They've taken the honours throughout this cross-country skiing competition, particularly in the men, where they've taken all nine medals available in the individual events, and they also won the relay. There it is. Andray Larkov wins gold. Raul Shakirzianov takes the silver. Artem Nikolaev takes the bronze.
When education meets sport and culture, what best promotes excellence in mind and body? Where do friendship, integrity, and achievement meet? which event gathers the best student athletes from around the world. The Universiade, the home of international university sports. Today's stars, tomorrow's